God speaks to us. Job chapter 33, verses 14 to 18. For God may speak in one way or in another, yet man does not perceive it. In a dream, in a vision of the night, when deep sleep falls upon men, while slumbering on their beds, then he opens the ears of men and seals their instruction, in order to turn man from his deed and conceal pride from man. He keeps back his soul from the pit and his life from perishing by the sword. Dreams. I'm sure all of us have had dreams, experienced dreams. When we wake up in the morning, we realize we've had a dream, and sometimes we don't know what to do with those dreams. And so this week, we're going to talk about dreams from a biblical perspective. Of course, we're not going to be able to cover everything that the Bible has to say, but I just want to do this as a way of introduction and just open our understanding to the fact that God can speak to us through dreams. Now, dreams, of course, can have different sources. The Bible tells us in Ecclesiastes chapter 5 and verse 3 that sometimes dreams come because of much activity. So, you know, there are things that we are so busy with and engaged with during the day that when you're asleep, our mind continues to work on those things. And so some of those things are just a natural and an extension of all the busyness and the activity of or whatever we've been going through during the day. Those are not the kind of dreams we want to focus on. You just wake up and let it go. Sometimes dreams can be nightmares where even sometimes demons and evil spirits intercept or disturb us at night and cause all of those things. And again, those are dreams we reject. We do not entertain them. We do not accept them. But there are also dreams that actually come from God. And like we read here in Job chapter 33, Job says here, we have a record here in Job 33, that God may speak to us in one way or another. He may speak to us in a dream, in a vision of the night. And that's the time that God opens our understanding and he seals our instruction. And he does this with a purpose. In this passage in Job, it's telling us that God is speaking in order to turn man from his wrong ways, in order to keep him from wrong things and from destruction, from going down to the pit, and his life from perishing from destruction. So God can speak to us through dreams in the night season, and he does it in order to communicate something to us. And what we want to do this week is we want to explore the different messages that God could speak to us through dreams, the different things that God can get across to us through dreams. And also in the course of this week, we will touch upon a little bit here and there on interpreting these dreams. Because when God speaks to us through dreams, it is not always a literal form of communication. By this we mean that many times the dreams that we have, the dreams that God gives to us, are riddles, or they are parables, or they are symbolic in nature. So they contain images that need interpretation and understanding. So we will talk about some of these things. Let's pray today, and as we begin our journey in talking about how God speaks to us through dreams. Father, we thank you that you're the God who speaks to us, and that you can speak to us through dreams. I pray that even this week, as we journey through your word concerning dreams, I pray that you will awaken this aspect of our lives, that God, you'll truly speak to us through dreams, even this week and on from here, God, that we will recognize when you are speaking and learn to receive from you the instruction you give to us through dreams that come to us. We open our hearts to receive from you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.